Hello, and welcome to ASL Basics with Ms. Colleen. I recommend this program for children ages 6 and up. However, you're never too early or too late to start learning a new language. Now, before we begin, we're going to be using our hands a lot in this. So, go ahead and shake them out a little bit. Give your hands a little bit of a stretch. Pull them gently back by the fingertips. Push them gently forward. Remember, you want to feel a stretch, but you don't want it to hurt. Signing should never hurt. It should always feel natural. The more natural it feels, the smoother your signing will be. And if at any point you need to take a break, that's fine. You can always pause the video, or you can always break it into smaller chunks and review the first couple letters back and forth on your own. All right. Now that our fingers are fairly well stretched out and hopefully warm them up a little bit if they aren't already. And remember, think of this as any other form of doing something new, like if you just started out exercising or something, your muscles might be a little bit sore. You're using a whole lot of muscles in your wrist that you may not be used to using. So the muscles in your wrist and in your fingers and your hands, they might get a little bit sore, and that's okay. Just remember to take breaks and make sure that everything you're doing, you might feel a bit of a stretch, but you never want it to hurt. So today let's go ahead and we are going to focus on the alphabet. Specifically, we're going to break it in half. We'll do A through M this time, and then we will do N through Z next time. So you can see here, I have a little bit of a guide for you so that you can see how the letters look before we begin. Now, your hands might not look exactly the same way that my hands do, and they might not look exactly the same way that these pictures do. That is perfectly fine. Everyone's hands are different, and you need to do what feels best for your hand. Now, the alphabet is very important because we use it in fingerspelling, especially in introducing yourself. When you're starting out, you might be fingerspelling a lot of words, asking someone what the sign for a certain word is. And you've also heard me say it a lot in some of my other videos, the word hand shape. That refers to the shape your hand makes when creating this letter. So what we will be learning is signs that go with the hand shape of the letter versus learning a word that starts with the letter. So like in school, you probably, when you were learning your alphabet, learned A is for apple. So instead, we're going to learn A is for sorry. Just make a small circle on your chest. You can see that this is the letter A in sign language. You just curl your fingers down, rest your thumb on the side. Whether it curls over the knuckles a bit or sticks out like mine does, either way is fine. Again, it should feel natural to you. So A, and then we use the same shape. Notice nothing changed to do the sign for sorry. Or I just make a small circle on my chest. Sorry. A. B. We're going to keep these four fingers together, and your thumb is just going to rest either below the knuckles. If your thumb goes down a little bit further, it can go down further. If it's a little bit higher, it might rest a little bit higher. That's fine. So, B. Use this for hello. Just use a small salute. You don't need to go too far out or too far down. It's just a little, hey. B. C is fairly simple. You're just going to make a C with your hand. So you can see there, those fingers look like they are pretty tight. Of course, that is a drawing and not an actual person holding it real tight. Will get painful very fast, and it also makes it difficult to get to other letters. So let your fingers space out a little bit. As long as you are keeping that C shape, it will still be readable. And C, we use for a sign like searching or looking for something. So like, I lost my keys. Where are my keys? I can't find them. I'm looking for them. So you might scrunch your face down a little bit like you would if you were looking for your keys. So C. D, again, that is a fairly simple one. We just make a circle with our thumb and our three fingers here. Let your index finger point straight up. D. And use this for deaf. Just tap your chin or close to the corner of your mouth and then back towards your ear. Deaf. You'll also see some people go from ear to chin. So whichever direction, it's still the same sign. D. The letter E is one that I find particularly tight, especially trying to do it like the picture does, where it's right at the knuckles. So I let my fingers relax a little bit. A good way for getting a natural hand shape for you for this one is to just shake out your hand and let it hang down. And then as you bring your wrist up, see how your fingers naturally curl when you rotate your wrist up. And then from there, just bring them in a little. So E. And we use this for a sign like emergency. You shake your hands back and forth. You're gonna want your face to express that something bad has happened, that there's an emergency. So emergency, you have to show that on your face. E. F, we just make a circle between our thumb and index finger. You can keep your other three fingers straight and close together. You can let them hang out apart a little bit more too. Either way is fine. So F, if we take two, meet them right at the tip and then kind of fidget this one. That's the sign for interpret. 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 F. G is done like this. It's just your index finger and thumb are going to point straight out and parallel to each other. Now, doing it the way you see in the picture, where it's like this, that feels very unnatural, doesn't it? So what you actually do is rotate your wrist in so that just the back of your hand and that straight out index finger is showing. And you use this for a sign like cat. Just kind of act like you're stroking a whisker. Cat. G. H, we're just going to bring our middle finger out and let your thumb rest on your ring finger. So H, you can use for a sign like hospital. I'm going to draw a cross on your shoulder or your upper arm. And think of the red cross to remember that one. So H. I is pretty easy. We're just going to make a fist. Let your thumb rest across your knuckles and hold your pinky out like you're drinking a nice fancy cup of tea. So I, you can use for something like idea. Oh, I have an idea. You're just gonna touch the I to your temple and bring it out, like, aha, idea. I. J is easy. We're just gonna take our I and we're gonna write a J in the air. J. Some of you, it might be easier to do with just the wrist. Some of you might need to get the elbow and arm involved. J. J. And we do this for a sign like juice. Juice. You just do a J right at the corner of your mouth. It doesn't have to be big. Just a simple little rotation. J. For K, you can see on this picture, they basically did a two and then put their thumb in the middle. I feel like this is not a particularly clear way of doing the letter K. It is also very stiff. So what I do and what I see most people do is they bring their middle finger down so that it points about the same level as the floor. So it points straight out. And then your other one points more or less straight up. Again, it's what feels natural for your hand. Leave your thumb in the middle of it there. And now you have a much more relaxed K. And for K, if you take two of them and rotate them around each other, that is the sign for kind or type. So if someone says they had juice this morning, you can ask them, oh, what kind? Oh, type. K. L. Again, we're back to a fairly self-explanatory one. You've probably all done this at some point in your life. You might have used the two L tricks, learning your left and right. Remember, the L that is the right way is your left. L. And so you can use this for a sign like lazy. And for that, you just take your L and just lazily tap it on your chest. Just feeling lazy today. I'm tired. L. And then finally, the letter M. This one definitely feels a little bit tricky. What you have to do is your thumb is going to come over and rest across your pinky. These fingers are going to come together and then rest over your thumb. Now, if curling your fingers completely over your thumb hurts, let them come out a little bit. You don't want them to go straight up because then it doesn't really look like an M anymore. But if you let them point straight out, it's easier on your wrist, and it will still read as the letter M. And we use this for a sign like Monday. Just take our M and rotate it in a circle. For that one, you do want to let it point a little bit more up because this is harder to see. So, Monday. M. All right, so let's review that. Let's review our first half of the alphabet really quick. We have A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M. Very good. Now, give your hands a good shakeout. Go ahead and let them rest because your hands might be feeling a little bit tired. And remember to check us out at Facebook and YouTube for updates. You can also go to cctexas.com/library to access our online catalog to see a full list of all of our virtual programs and to use our online browsing feature, the new book alerts, author checks, and book newsletter. And I hope to see you guys again soon for the second half of the alphabet. Bye-bye!